Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Spotric Games, and I am your host, Spot. And here we have Dark Souls 3. Now, I have some plans for this one. Yes, just like I have plans for FTL. No, I have not forgotten FTL. I promise it's going to come back, and I just need to finish editing and recording my shenanigans. Anyway, back to the point. Yeah, you like that point as I stab the guy? We're going to be doing a fun little Dark Souls 3 run. Me and Scorched Panda, a.k.a. Brad, we're going to be doing a joint run on this game. So I am going to do the first part where I get to the point where we can actually summon our friends. And then from that point forward, Brad will be joining us. And we're going to be doing a co-op run-through of Dark Souls 3. Or Dank Souls, depending on your mood. Alright, here we go. I have started off as a thief. My endgame goal, I want to try a faith build. Perhaps faith strength. I think Brad's going for something similar when we were talking. Or actually, I think I'm going to scratch that. I'm going for dex if I can live. But this is not a good start, guys. Hoo! Gooey! Okay. Charge up and hit. There we go. So, yeah, huh? 1, 2, 3. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 does the same as a charge up, basically. So, realistically, it doesn't matter. Okay. Oh. Puncher, okay. You want to be a punch man? That's all right, come on. Antoro! All right, this guy right here. Here you go! I can't believe he missed. I really can't. Okay, here we go. And charge, hit, and it was freebie. One more freebie. Oh, I was gonna say, I thought I stunned him. If I stunned him with a dagger, I'm impressed with myself. Oh. Okay. All right. Oh. Okay. Yes. We're okay, guys. We're okay. Yeah! First try with a freaking thief. Okay. Alright. Those of you new to the series, in case you have never even heard or seen Dark Souls, first off, where you bloody been, man? It's Dank Souls. It's this game. This game. Here, you know what? This is what it's about, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go ahead and go forward after we activate this bonfire. Bonfires are kind of your checkpoints. This is what you go to rejuvenate yourself, to revitalize. Your Estus flask is what keeps you alive, and that's where you go to get more if you need more. So here we go. Now you're going to notice I have a slight glow about me. That means I am alive. I'm not an undead. Well, at least for now. So, I actually look pretty healthy under my hood. Let's see, we're gonna go ahead and get a broken straight sword. That's fine. I can never remember where to go without falling off. Over there, okay. Alright. Come on. Let's see, kick? Alright, that's still kick. I have to remember for times like this. Oh! No. There we go. Yeah, okay. Okay, we're all right, guys. We are all right. A little on the scary side, but we are all right. We're gonna get this guy. Now, Dark Souls holds a special place in my heart because it is ridiculously tough. Like, it's one of those games you play when you really want to feel a challenge. And you will feel it pretty consistently. The boss fights, some of them are just ridiculous. Admittedly, I have some bosses I cannot solo yet. Like, as long as I have played this cursed series, I still have some. I just, soloing is not an option for me. Ugh, okay. Gotcha. The advantage of the knife is it is, as you can see, lightning quick. Let's see. Okay, nothing down there. And that's where we're gonna go. Now you can explore around here. There is a series of things up there. There's more to explore over here to the right. There's more to explore over to the left. The downside is there's some really big challenges that we're not quite ready for. I feel good with my skill, but I don't feel invincible. Let's make that very well cleared. So, all right, let's come down here. This is our hub, Firelink Shrine. This is where it's at. We can talk to people here. Oh, hey, how's it going?
Another one roused from the sleep of death.
Yes.
Well, you're not alone. We unkindled are worthless. Can't even die right.
Now, don't be so hard on yourself.
Gives me conniptions.
Well?
And it'd have us seek the lords of Cinder and return them to their molding thrones. But we're talking true legends with the metal to link the fire. We're not fit to lick their boots.
Someone's a little down in the dumps, methinks.
Don't you think?
No, I don't. Yeah, alright. As you can tell, everyone around here is quite happy. However, hello, Maiden. She is going to be our saving grace because this is how we level up right here.
The lords have left their thrones. To this end, I am a...
Alright. Right now, I'm just going to talk. I actually need to verify something real quick on what I was going to build. I took notes.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Okay, I am back. So, I have re-found what I need to do. So, this is going to be a Faith Dexterity build. Faith is, I think, one of the stronger here. Oh, I have my motion controller. Whee! As I'm spinning in my chair. There's your visual. Okay. Let's see. We need to level up.
Then touch, take nourishment.
Now, first things first. What do we need? Luck's good. Faith is our lowest. Dexterity is 13. So let's bring up Faith. And strength. You know what? Let's get strength at least to 10. Let's get everything to at least 10. Because I want to say we want it. Yeah, we need a little bit more vitality than what we're going to be going with here. There we go.
Ashen One, Sovereign, I will show the ashen.
Sorry, as I plow through this, a lot of it she's already said. So, the other advantage here, and as soon as I can remember, there he is. Say hello to our one and only blacksmith and our actual maiden here. Lots of charitable things. Sorry, I'm going to be plowing through because everyone in this game inherently talks really slow and drawn out. And then they have their own dedicated laugh time of or at least some to that effect. So we're going to bypass that. But more importantly, and almost humorously, that's what we need right there. The co-op soapstone. So, short little episode. I'm not going to progress to the point where we're going to beat any more baddies, but I will go ahead and show you guys around some of the stuff we're going to do. That way, when me and Brad do pair up, it's going to be no surprises. You guys are knowing what to expect. Let's see. You can also sell items. Ashen, I don't think we want to sell anything currently.
Sure, bring more souls.
Let's see what we can do here. See what I mean? Do you see what I mean? That's the dedicated laugh line. The blacksmith is our hero, though. Oh, hello, blacksmith.
Well, a newcomer, I see.
Yes.
I am not as a humble smith, forging weapons. You're in search of the toilsome journey I'd wage.
Yes, good arms. Let me smithy him. You got it. All right, so nothing to repair, which is good. We are going to give ourselves all health, because right now we do not have any magic worthwhile. We don't even have anything to reinforce a bloody weapon with, for crying out loud. Look at that. Nothing. Alright.
Be careful. I don't want to see my work squandered.
Of course not. Squandered. Okay, so, to get to where we need to go, we actually will throw the sword that we captured earlier from our one shot, baby, right in there. Perfect. We're going to rest here at the bonfire, and we're going to get our first official area to travel to. The High Wall of Lothric. And poof, we're gone. Okay. Here we go. This is where things get fun. What's back here? Is that something? Nope, that's That is not a thing. Now, what I love about this is there are so many options to explore. You have like four different ways that you can get to where you need to go from here, all depending on what you want to do. Now, one thing I'm kind of neglecting is I forget this guy. What? Am I going to punch him? Punch him? Yeah. See that? Do the dance. Do the dance. Like I'm dabbing, but terribly at it. All right. There we go. Don't know what that does. Oh, it's like a quick release. Okay. That's kind of cool. So, it shows you how much I actually use bows and arrows in this game. I'm traditionally a sword. I do favor my dex builds. I like the speed. I really like the speed. Let's see. Is there anything else down here I should be aware of? Oh, bonfire. Okay, we're safe at the bonfire. Bonfires usually will mean you're safe. All right, let's look around here, shall we? So we have this over here. I hear someone. I hear the gasping of someone. Aha. Here we go. 1, 2, and 3. Nice and quick and easy. Now let's see where else we can go. So we can go over here to the right. Zombie dog and a couple of other things. The dogs are painfully frustrating. And then we can, of course, come over here. So we do have options. Let's go over here. Not feeling like a dog right this moment. Let's see. Any of these can turn? He's going to turn. Come on. See, I like that because it gets his attention. Come on. Oh my goodness, come on. Oh, I thought I could undercut him. Nope, negative. Did not get under his swipe. Oh, we don't want him to alert someone. No, you don't. So, his little lantern, if he would have actually gotten a chance to do what he was going to do, would have pretty much alerted anything and everything. And I think it even makes these guys all of a sudden turn on me. Granted, these guys are nothing. Take 5. Get some rest. Yep, you all worked hard for it. There you go. And I'm just mainly after some soul points. That's alright. There you go. And of course, there you go. Give you guys a bit of reprieve. And I don't think there's anything to actually gain over here. Oh, someone dropped something. Broken straight sword. Okay. Take backstab. Let's see. There we go. Didn't mean to kick. That was here. You know what? Screw your table. Gah! Uh-huh. I hear someone. There you are. See, they like to creep up on you, at least they think they're being sneaky. Yeah, there we go. Okay. We got that thing up there. That's where we came down. And this way is completely blocked off. Oh, hey, big guy. Okay, so we can't go that way. And as you can see, there's a way to get up there somehow. Admittedly, I have not beaten Dark Souls 3 yet. Oops. Now, I have something to confess to you all. I have beaten all of the other Dark Souls and Demon Souls and Bloodborne, but unfortunately, I have not beaten Dark Souls 3. So, this is the one I'm very least familiar with. Oh, hello. What's up? How's your day going? You good? You good? Yeah? Well, I got something for you. It's called a quick arrow. Oh, that's not what I wanted. It's called a quick arrow launch. Oh, you waited for me to aim. You little sneak. Come on. Okay, the fire arrows are getting dangerous. Not my finest moment here. Let's backstab you. What's that arrow? Heal up. Okay. So this, since we're going to be joining Grad, just kind of take this as a moment to kind of check out all the shenanigans that can happen here. And just like a good game, and in real life, going up against five very, very angry men is not a good idea to do alone. Whoa. Oh, come on. All right. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna get hosed right here. And I am out of heals. All right. Fine. Let's do this. How do you like me now? Oh, wrong button. Where is he at? Man, my PlayStation 4 controller on my new system's really sensitive. I'm just gonna deal with you, Mr. Archer, in the only way I know how. Oh, you sneak. Ooh! Okay. Since what's-his-face just stand there trying to see what's going on. No! Are you kidding me? Okay. Okay. I gotta watch out for that stupid archer. He is wrecking me down there. Alright, let's leave this guy. Let's do this. Are you kidding me? Okay. Definitely not my finest moment here. You know what? I got an idea. Hold on. This is just so crazy, it might work here. If we come down here, because he's going to take his sweet time. Let's see. No. I want to hotkey it. Oh my gosh, how do I hotkey? Oh, it's been too long. Inventory, no. No. The first one. Equipment. There we go. Ha! Look, I had so much time I could do that here. Eat this. Wow, that's a good shield you got there, man. Let's just sneak around you then. Oh! There. Finally. Oh, man. You took all my flasks to get here, guys? I am rusty. Okay. Let's go back. Reset at the bonfire. And resetting at the bonfire does, unfortunately, reset everything and everybody around you. So, that part's not fun. But, realistically, it's a lot better than just dying right about now. Oh, is there a way to drop down? Not that way. Okay. Why am I hearing noises? I'm hearing noises. I know you guys are hearing that. I'm not going nuts, I don't think. Okay. Oh, and that's another player. This phantom you see here running. That is another live player. This game works on a constantly connected system. So, no matter what, you're going to see ghosts, you're going to see phantoms. There's also other opportunities for things to go wrong without giving things away. So, lots of ways to play this game, lots of different things. Let's go the other way, just since we're kind of going light. We don't want to go too far ahead of it without Brad. Let's see here. Where you get this guy. Oh, hey, what's up, dude? Gah-ha-ha. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. And yes, I'll take this. I'm also randomly killing these. Oh, how'd you get up here? What? That scared the crap out of me. Oh, you know that feeling where something scares you and you get like all the tingly sensation all across your back and shoulders and neck? Yep. He gave it to me. Stupid dog. You want some too, dog? Oh. Yeah, you know what? Let's go. Take that, dog. Ugh. Anybody else down there who wants some? Oh, yep. He wants some. He wants a lot of some. Okay, you can have some more. Fall, please. Thank you. Okay, slice and dice. Oh, I don't hit hard, but I can sure keep on swinging, which is the important thing about this build. And I should have just kept on swinging. I don't know why I didn't. Okay. Okay. Whew. The dog still rattled me. Like, my heart is still palpitating from that stupid dog sneaking up on me. Okay, let's move on. So we got big guy. Lots of growling. That's where. Let's see if we can sneak up on him. I think he'll turn around before I get a chance. But let's find out. Yep, he turned around. No! Not with that. I will backstab you. We're gonna two-hand our sword, or a weapon. You can two-hand every weapon you get. Like, look, we need to two-hand the shield. Wah! Super defense! One of the small little things that you don't really think about, but two-handing the sword, of course, gives you more strength in your swings. Might be a little bit slower, but in the grand scheme of things, I don't think you're really gonna notice. But if you're looking for a bit more power, you're trying to just kind of muscle through, switch that mode up, you enter the I'm gonna kill everything mode, and good luck. Let's see what's up here. Throw up the shield. Oh yeah. You. I really hate archers. So basically, that quick shot doesn't do the damage of the aim shot. Come on. Oh, that was a fair trade. All right, let's see what we got here. Anything? Oh, we got some loot over here. Remember, the name of the game is loot. If you can get yourself a weapon that's worthwhile, if you can get yourself an armor that's worth... Oh, he was going to turn. Some of these guys do turn into very big, terrible, nasty things, and we stopped him before he did. Which, thank the goodness, because, man, that would not be fun. What's around here? Anything? Hello? Anything? Okay. Ooh, okay. Anything up here? Nothing that we can get up to right now. And nope, nothing there. And nothing back there? Okay. Well, guys, I think that's pretty much like an introduction here to Dark Souls. You got to see a boss. That was kind of cool. You get to see me. Look, I'm a little bloody. Sorry about that. You get to see me just kind of run around and cause some trouble here. It's a challenging game. If you're looking for a difficult game, if you're looking for something that pushes you to the edge, it punishes you until you learn. That's the best way I can put it. If you are constantly going up against a boss and you're losing, then you need to change your way of approach, and it will continuously punish you until it makes you realize that, oh, that way it really genuinely is not working. Let's see if I can get him. Ready, and... neck shot. Yeah, arrow through your head, that sucks. Oh, he doesn't think it's funny. Oh, see, this is what happens. He got his battle cry out. He saw me. Oh, we only have one guy that's actually charging? That's fine. In other places, it's not that generous. We'll put it that way. So now that we have some souls, the way this game's done is you just sit here and you farm. And you farm until you feel comfortable or until you think you've got enough that you need. So we're going to go back to Firelink Shrine. Oh, we could have summoned someone. I could have showed you how that works, but you'll see that plenty when we do this with Brad here. So now we got some souls. We say, okay, groovy. While we're at it, though, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to assign our soapstone to be right there. Okay. And the soapstone, I basically go and I throw it in and I help people. In fact, maybe I'll do that real quick. Reinforce my weapon, sir. Let's see. So that'll jump it up quite a bit, give me a little bit more damage. The rest are pretty much crap. I think I'm going to save my tie tonight until I get a weapon that I'm actually going to hang on to for a bit. I don't think she has anything, especially not for 1,300 souls. You know what? Let's go help someone. That'll be our thing. Let's go help somebody. So if you want to help somebody, you buy the white soapstone from our little friendly merchant in there. Then you say, okay, here you go. Boom. This is me. So when they see it, they say, oh, hey, Spotric wants to help you. And then they say, okay, help me. And then it'll summon me in. In the meantime, we can wander around and actually, you know, still play the game. And we should get a memo here soon that says, oh, you're being summoned. And we should get a memo here saying, oh, you're being summoned. Now, I'm talking to everyone in here. I am command. Let's do this. Jump for joy. And super joy. Yeah. Come on. Someone's got to summon me. We got to see how this works. I want to help you. Here we go. We're being summoned to another world. That way it doesn't count in mine. Hey. Come on. Maybe. Connect on through to the other side. Here we go. With Ghetto Booty and Darkseid, we got this. We're going to wave. Oh, hey, guys. One important thing. This game doesn't have voice chat. You cannot communicate with these guys at all. Only through gestures and waves. That's the only way it happens. Now, the other thing you're at mercy for is this is something that is on the... or the host, if I can talk. So it's a peer hosting game. So we are at the mercy of whoever is hosting us website. So as you can see, we get a little bit of lag. We hit him twice. Even though we've hit him, they're not taking damage like they fully should. So that's just part of it. And apparently, we're not doing that great. And apparently, we're dead. We helped. We helped good. Yeah! Who we got here? Ash of Arendelle. Let's wave to you. Hello. Look at her. She's got kind of like a little barbarian thing going on for her. We're Conan the Barbarian. There you go. Am I going first? Is that what you're trying to tell me here? Now, I'm probably the terrible one not knowing here. But if I'm not mistaken... No. Let's see. If I'm not mistaken here, see, we're gonna have some lag issues. I don't know if it's us or them, but either way, we're gonna make it work. Oh, these guys. That was smooth. Okay. Let's see what we got. Why won't you let me backstab? Okay, that's fine. He got riggedy wrecked. That's right. I went there. Riggedy wrecked. Man, she is just marching on through here. Oh, no you don't. And he'll think about dying. Oh. Okay, guys. This is it. Here's the bad news. We're getting invaded by somebody. This is another player who's actually invading us. Let that be known. It's an actual other player who is invading us. Let's see how this goes. Now, she also has the choice. Oh, is that him down there? I think that's him getting ready to come up the ladder. He's going down the ladder first. Okay. See, and that's the thing is, I have no idea where this guy's hiding. Oh, there he is. Hello. So, this guy's very clearly, I would easily say, hacked. Very easily, I would say this is a hacked person. Why did I not have my knife out? That was about stupid. Woo! Thank you, team. Wow. Okay. That was not fun. Oh, this guy wants to change. No. No, how did I not get him in time? No. Remember. Oh, God. Okay, guys. That is a taste of Dark Souls. You died is a phrase that happens often. And I thought I stopped him, but unfortunately, due to lag, my hit didn't register as a stun, which gave him just enough time to get it off. Oh, man. Okay. So that's Dark Souls, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to go ahead and drop me a like. If you want to see more of this, absolutely hit me a subscription or feel free to drop a like. We'll make it work. Like I say, me and Brad's going to be kicking this up here. Absolutely looking forward to it. Woo! All right, guys. Again, this is Spot with Spotric Games. This was Dark Souls 3. Thank you so much. Have yourselves a spectacular day. You all deserve it. Hit the subscribe button if you feel inclined. And I'll see you all later. This is Spot signing out. Goodbye. Oh, hold on. I got to do this right. I'm sorry. This is Spot signing out. Goodbye.